Hi, it's Mandy, and I'm here to work you through task 3 of training 2. Let's take a deeper look at your data.
We will begin by choosing mixture view from the center column. As you can see, you have a lot of data at your fingertips to help you make those data-informed decisions. To keep it simple, let's focus on the skills that you've assigned for now. Here you can see whether the skill is active, the date that it was added, the skill's description, as well as the percentage of proficient students. This number represents the percentage of students who have achieved green, silver, or gold on each skill. Because it takes time for students to level up their skills, this percentage is an indicator of whether your students are demonstrating long-term retention. The longer a skill has been active for your students to work on in mixture view, the higher you would like to see that proficiency percentage. So, you can easily reorder the data by clicking on the Date Added heading to focus on those older skills. You also have the option to include additional metrics on your mixed review report. To do this, click on the 3 gray rectangles to the right of your screen. You can choose to include the accuracy percentage, how many students have no attempts on each skill, as well as how many students fall into each of the color ratings. Let's go ahead and add the accuracy percentage. Notice that you can now see both the proficiency and accuracy percentages for each skill. What exactly is the difference between these two metrics? Accuracy represents the percentage of time students answer correctly on their first attempt. The proficiency percentage focuses on accuracy over time. In order for students to level up to green, silver, or gold, they must continue to demonstrate accuracy beyond the first day. The proficiency percentage is the metric to watch to ensure your students are working towards a long-term understanding of those skills. Let's dive into the data further by clicking on the proficiency percentage. When you click on the percentage, you can easily see a breakdown of your class by viewing the color distribution. In this view, you can see which students are proficient with this skill, and which students may need some additional help. You can also see the distribution of your students' accuracy if you'd like to check on how often they are answering correctly on their first attempt. By using the arrows at the top of the screen, you can continue to investigate the other skills that you have assigned to your class. Keep your eye on that proficiency percentage to ensure that your students are demonstrating long-term retention. As you dig into your data, you may come across a skill that has a low proficiency but a high accuracy. How can that happen? It is important to focus on when the skill was added. As a reminder, the longer the skill has been in mixed review, the higher you want to see that proficiency percentage. If you come across an older skill with low proficiency and high accuracy, that can be concerning. This often means that your students haven't had the opportunity to practice the skill enough to level up their color rating. You may want to provide an opportunity for your students to have focused practice with this skill. Remember that newer skills will have a lower proficiency because it takes time for your students to level up their new skills. It is perfectly acceptable to see a newer skill with low proficiency and high accuracy. As time progresses, you want to see that proficiency percentage increase. Now that you've had a chance to dive into your class data, the next task will work you through some action steps to ensure your students are getting opportunities to showcase their long-term retention.